Hello, hello. This video is for women leaders who work within male-dominated industries. My name is Jacqueline Twilley. I'm president at ZeroGap.co. At ZeroGap, we curate leadership learning experiences for companies in male-dominated industries. Now, I love working with companies in male-dominated industries because there is this awesome opportunity to be competitive and innovative with a diverse team. Research shows us that companies who are diverse in leadership, they innovate at a faster rate than their competitors. And on top of that, they increase profitability. And I think it's like 30% over the last report I read over their competitors who have non-diverse leadership teams. So when we think about how amazing this opportunity is for companies to continue to be competitive and grow, this is just awesome. It just makes common sense if you're in business to make money. All right, so today we're talking about the latte method for teams. So what is latte? Latte is an acronym. It's a negotiation framework. So it's 5 points to it. The first part is L, look at the details. The second point, anticipate challenges. Third, think about the walk away point. The fourth, talk it through. And then the fifth step is evaluate options. So when it comes to teams, managing teams, whether they are remote or in person, you're going to have nuances and challenges. Ultimately, you're negotiating every day. Most people think of negotiation as only sitting at a table, maybe with a contract in front of them, hammering out details. But negotiation is as simple as trying to coordinate a meeting and getting different times on the calendar and saying, can you do this instead of this? Yes, negotiation is that simple. And this is the thing. Negotiation is like a muscle. The more you use it, the stronger it becomes. So if you have leaders in your organization who self-profess, say, I'm not a good negotiator, here's an excellent opportunity to find ways in teams every day to collaborate, whether it's within one team or across departments, to collaborate more efficiently and effectively to help you accelerate your results. So when you're going through this latte method for teams, think about what problem are you solving? At the end of the day, negotiation is problem solving. So what problem is at hand? When people come to a table for negotiation, each party has something that the other one wants. There is an exchange of value happening there. So when you put that on a table and you understand what is one group's interest versus the other, then you're able to build on that. Now, some people say in negotiations, one person wins and one person loses. I just don't believe that philosophy. I believe in win-win negotiations. Now, there are different types of negotiations. I get that. But here's the deal. When you're talking about teams, whether you have, you're negotiating within a team or you're negotiating across departments, the goal isn't for one person in your company to lose and the other to win. The goal is to work together so that you're collaborating efficiently, you're communicating effectively to reach an ultimate goal. So maybe one department has a goal to cut costs and another department has a goal to get something done quickly. And that's where the negotiation takes place. How do we do both of these things? So you put all of the issues on the table and then you look at your areas of potential agreement. And from there, you get to build on these stepping stones, going back to think about your walk away point. So you're saying, oh, Jacqueline, are you saying that I'm going to walk away internally from a team member or from another team in a department? Well, I'm saying there is going to be a point where you can reach a level of frustration where it's no longer effective to communicate at that time. So if you understand what your walk away point is, if you understand at which point I need to call a timeout, we need to regroup, maybe we need to bring in a mediator, it really helps you to understand that upfront so that you're not wasting time. In business, time is money. If you spend too much time trying to solve a problem, your competitors can swoop in, they can offer that solution to your customers, or better yet, you can lose tons of money. Not better yet, worse yet. You can lose a ton of money. So then you go to the next step and you talk it through. Now, when we talk about the talking it through phase, that fourth step in the latte method when it comes to teams and problem solving, you want to bring the right people to the table, the decision makers. Sometimes you do preliminary work, getting a little tongue-tied here. Sometimes you do that upfront work and you might have different people involved. But ultimately, if the decision makers are not involved in the process of talking it through, you can spend, again, a lot of time turning wheels just to end up with a solution that says, no, that's not going to work. And you're really trying to move forward. So bring in the right decision makers when you're talking it through. Now, when you evaluate options, here's the deal. There's more than one way to reach a solution to a problem. So you might come in with a frame of reference that this is my way, and the other person or other team may say, this is my way. There is an opportunity there to get creative, to think outside of the box, as we say, and to find a solution that works for everyone. Oftentimes, it's when we think outside of the box, that's where the magic happens. That's where we find a solution that we can replicate in different areas of the business, and we can double down, and we can be more efficient and effective and collaborate more seamlessly in the future. So when it comes to using the latte method for teams, you can use this within a team. You can use this cross-departmental. It all starts with understanding the problem and then following those five steps in the latte method to reach a resolution. My name is Jacqueline Twilley, president at ZeroGap.co. We curate the leadership experiences for companies in male-dominated industries. Until next time, continue to emulate excellence and eliminate excuses.